friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa, and in this video I'm going to address a question which students have asked me dozens of times. So the question is that, ma'am, we have tried to go through notes, we have tried to read so many books, we have attempted so many previous year papers, but still our score is not improving. A lot of students ask my team on daily basis that what we should do in order to crack NET. It's been 3 or 4 attempts and we are not able to clear NET. Some or the other time it is either by 2% or 3% we fail, and we are really disheartened. What should we do? So I thought of taking up this question and making a video about it so that I can address all the students out there who are struggling with this issue. So this video is specifically for those who have either attempted twice or thrice in the NET exam and yet are not able to clear it, or for the first timers who are trying to go through the previous year papers, give them as a mock test, and yet find that they are not able to improve their score. Every time they attempt a paper, their score remains the same in spite of the fact that they have put in so much effort in order to learn so many new things, in order to practice and rectify their mistakes. So for all of you guys, here is the video. But before we get into the details of the video, I would like to talk about a very important story which is very dear to my heart. This story is very relevant from the point of view of this video. So the story is about the great scientist Edison. So Thomas Alva Edison, the great scientist, he used to work in his laboratory day in and day out. Once upon a time, while he was working in his laboratory caught fire and the entire laboratory was destroyed by fire. A lot of reporters came to his house in order to ask him, and one of the reporters asked him that, how do you feel now that you find the entire hard work of your lifetime getting destroyed by fire? And at this point, Edison said a very beautiful line. He said that, no, it's not the hard work that is getting destroyed. It is my mistakes which are getting destroyed. So now I have the opportunity to start afresh, to make a new start, and to understand how science works, and to come up with so many new theories. So that is the passion that you have to keep. Even if you have failed twice, thrice, and you have not yet succeeded, I'm telling you that if you have your spirits up, there's nobody who can take you away from your goal. So I'm going to talk about the topic of this video now, but before that, put in the comment section if you want me to make any new videos on any of the questions that is troubling you, that is hindering your NET preparation. I would love to answer them in my frequent videos. The very first tip that I would like to give to each one of you out there is to make note of all your mistakes. I have seen a lot of students who keep on solving previous year papers. They might be scoring 30 out of 50 or 25 out of 50, but they keep on solving. They never look back at the paper they have answered and see where they are making mistakes. So what happens in turn is that their mistakes keep on repeating. They are not able to improve their score because they are not working on the weak areas. So the very first thing that you have to do whenever you attempt any previous year paper or you attempt any mock test is that, keep a notebook handy. After solving the paper, when you are marking and grading yourself, make note of all the questions that you have answered wrong, and then look at it, evaluate each of these questions and see what kind of mistake did you make. It is very important. Unless and until you don't evaluate, you will keep on making the same mistake. Okay, and you will figure out after solving 2-3 papers that aap same mistakes har bar kar rahe ho. Isliye har bar aapka score bhi wahi aa raha hai. Aisa nahi hai aap roz nayi mistakes karte hain. Aap wahi mistakes ko repeat kare ja rahe ho, but because you have never noted them down, never evaluated it, aapko pata hi nahi hai ki aap kya galtiyan kar rahe ho. Let me give you a very simple analogy. Agar main ek din mein apne ghar pe 5 ya 6 items banati hu khane mein jisme doodh dala jata hai, I have to put in some milk, be it tea, be it some sweets, or be it kheer, or be it anything. Now, if I find that all the things that I'm preparing that day, the taste is very different. It's not that great. So should I question my cooking abilities? No, before I start questioning my cooking abilities, let me first see what is the common ingredient. Maybe us din aapka doodh hi kharab aaya hai. The quality of milk is not so great. That is why everything that has milk in it is going to taste bitter. The same thing might apply in case of your previous year questions that you are attempting. You're making the same mistake again and again, and you question yourself saying that I am not good at paper one, I am not good at logical reasoning, I'm not good at mathematical reasoning. Don't question yourself. First see, you might be making the same mistake, and if you correct that mistake, if you rectify that error, from the next day your score is going to go up, really up, and you'll be surprised to know that. Now, after you have made notes on all the mistakes that you have made in a particular test, it is important to look at the questions and evaluate and see the nature of these mistakes. There can be different kind of mistakes which a student can make. There might be a silly mistake. You might have just done some calculation wrong because you were not focused at that time. Or maybe it is a mistake that you did because you were feeling pressure. आप प्रेशर में जब आते हैं तो आप बहुत सही चीज़ें गलत कर देते हैं. आपका दिमाग उस तरह से चल ही नहीं पाता जिस तरह से जब वो रिलैक्स्ड होता है तब चलता है. सो मे बी बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेशर यू आर मेकिंग सर्टेन मिस्टेक्स. और यू माइट फाइंड दैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द लैंग्वेज ऑफ क्वेश्चन. दिस आई अंडरस्टूड व्हेन आई वॉज इन माई 11th स्टैंडर्ड एंड आई यूज टू गेट सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस ऑफ अकाउंटेंसी. आई हैड कॉमर्स विथ माई सेल्फ व्हेन आई वॉज इन 11th. सो अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस which came in accountancy were not being answered by me properly because I was not able to understand what the question was saying. It was not that I don't know how to calculate depreciation or how to transfer some credits to another person's account, but I was not able to understand what the question was trying to say. So you might also be making the same mistake. Mostly I've seen students who get stuck somewhere in paper one. They are not able to understand assertion reason statements. They find the language very tricky, or they are not able to understand what is that cheat code which they need to find from the question. So make sure that if it is a silly mistake, you have to handle it differently. If it is a mistake that you are doing just because you were under pressure, you have to handle it differently. If it is a mistake because you're not able to understand the question and the language of the question, then you have to look at it differently. And then after all this, you will find certain questions which you will be answer in a wrong manner just because you have not worked on your weak area. So all of us have our own strength and weakness. Even in paper one, you might find that teaching aptitude and research is your strength, whereas logical reasoning or data interpretation is your weakness. Now you have to do a SWOT analysis. What is a SWOT analysis? It's basically strength and weakness analysis. You have to understand aapke kya kya weak areas hai, identify and then start working on them. And once you start working on them, you will find that aapka har bar ke test ka score jo hai wo dheere dheere upar jayega. Jo cheez aati hai usse hi bar bar practice karne se kuch nahi होगा. जहां आप अटक रहे हैं, जो क्वेश्चंस गलत हो रहे हैं, स्टार्ट वर्किंग ऑन दोज क्वेश्चन. दैट इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू गिव यू दोज एक्स्ट्रा मार्क्स बाय व्हिच यू कैन इजीली क्वालिफाई नेट. Now that we have identified where we are going wrong, we have identified the nature of our weaknesses, it is important for you to start practicing. But then you don't have to practice the entire question paper again. You don't have to give the test again. No, that is going to take so much of your time and that is going to be fruitless. So what you need to do is that you need to know the particular sections which you have to practice again. So practice only what you are missing is very important. If you have ever seen cricketers in the net practice, you will find that they don't keep on playing cricket, as in if a bowler is there, so he'll not throw balls which he's good at. If a bowler is good at Yorker, he's not going to practice just giving Yorkers. No, he's going to practice what he is weak at. In the similar fashion, you have to keep on practicing on your weak areas. You have to keep on practicing those questions which you are getting wrong. And within few days, you will see that those questions will become your strengths. So what is important here is that just like we had Arjuna who focused on that bird's eye, similarly, your focus should be there on the questions which you got wrong or on the areas which are your weak areas. So make sure that you forget everything from the question paper and only focus on the questions which you are getting wrong. You keep on practicing them and make sure you become better at them day by day. So I hope that the 3 points that I've discussed in this video is going to help you improve your score and will help you to qualify this exam. Just believe in yourself, have the passion, and keep on working on your deficiencies. Keep on working on your errors. Rectify your errors and get your goal. So that's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to ArpitaKarwa.com.